We actually did not witness Dominic's first seizure. Right before his third birthday, I walked into our living room. He had been playing with his siblings, and I found him on his back, seemingly unresponsive on our living room floor. He was obviously rushed to the emergency room. He came to, everything checked out, and by the end of our visit, they informed us that they thought that he had suffered a seizure. Upon returning home, 5 minutes after getting home, he suffered his first witnessed tonic-clonic seizure. And from there, things just snowballed. He developed 4 different seizure types. He was placed on 4 anti-epileptic medications and was still having up to 1,000 seizures a day. So his seizure onset was extremely explosive.
I think something that speaks to the complexity of pediatric epilepsy is that it's really the pediatric epilepsies. And so there's not only lots of different types of epilepsies, but there's also lots of different genes that can cause these epilepsies.
A few months into our journey, Dominic was eventually given a probable diagnosis of Dusa syndrome, or Duse syndrome as most people call it, which is a rare type of pediatric epilepsy, which presents in early childhood with multiple seizure types and is notoriously resistant to medication.
Dusa syndrome can be caused by pathogenic variants in a number of different genes. So for instance, GLUT1, CHD2, and SLC6A1. 20 years ago, we knew there were maybe a handful of genes that were implicated in epilepsy. But due to technological advancements, we now know that there are hundreds of different types of genes that can cause this condition. And this is really important for families because it means that we're giving them answers in terms of why their child is affected with a specific genetic condition. Yet we still have work to do, in that there are many families who are still searching for answers.
We have tried 6 different anti-epileptic medications in an attempt to control Dominic's seizures, and all 6 of those medications have failed him. The only treatment that has proven effective in giving us seizure control is a medically prescribed version of the ketogenic diet.
The exciting thing about identifying all of these new genes implicated in epilepsy is that we can now study them in the lab, and we can understand how, when an individual has a pathogenic variant in a particular gene, what happens to that cell, and what are the disease mechanisms that underlie epilepsy. This, in turn, allows us to move towards the goal of precision medicine, where eventually we'd love to treat individuals with epilepsy based on their genetic variant in a more tailored fashion.
Dominic is doing great today. The ketogenic diet has given us our life back. He's been primarily daytime seizure-free for 2 years. And compared to having 1,000 seizures a day, there aren't words to describe our gratitude for this treatment that has given us our son back. He's running, he's playing with his brother and sister, and he's just pretty much a typical 5-year-old boy. Cure is important to our family because we know that the research they fund is our best bet to finding a cure for Dominic and the millions of people who are suffering from epilepsy. Join me and the epilepsy community for Unite to Cure Epilepsy on Thursday night, September 24th at 7 p.m. Central Time on Facebook Live and YouTube Live.